Hi everyone, a very good morning to one and all, and a warm welcome to the first session of Java programming, that is OOPS through Java, object oriented programming through Java. So this particular subject is included in the syllabus in order to bring the analytical skills of object-oriented programming, and at the same time this subject is used to overall development of problem solving and critical analysis and formal introduction of Java programming language. So in today's session we start with unit number 1, and we are going to see the topic regarding basics of Java programming. And I am V. Dinesh Babu from the Department of CSC of Jabrol Engineering College. And today's session, let us start with basics of Java programming language. So here I have two questions in my mind, and the solution for these two questions will be our first session in today's first session in Java. My two questions which are in my mind are: why Java is object oriented programming language, and my second question is how Java is machine independent. So let us see what is an object oriented programming language and what are the different points that are involved in order to make a programming language as object oriented programming language. And at the same time, let us see what is machine independence, right? And which languages are machine independent and which languages are not machine independent. So let us start with finding the solution for the first question. So my first question is, why Java is an object-oriented programming language? So let us look at what is an object-oriented programming language, and then let us find whether the Java is an object-oriented programming language or not. So it is my first question, why Java is an object-oriented programming language? So if you observe this particular diagram, right? So the heading was represented as OOPS, Object Oriented Programming System. So that means these are the different concepts that are involved in object oriented programming system. So the names of the concepts are object, class, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, and encapsulation. So the combination of all these six concepts is called as an object oriented programming system, right? So let us see the definitions of all these six concepts in the future sessions. Maybe in the next session we will see the definitions of all these six concepts in the next session. So don't worry, I will show the definitions. Now, in this session, we are going to find the solution for this particular question, why Java is object-oriented programming language. So before going to see whether Java is an object-oriented or not, let us see what is an object-oriented programming language. So any programming language, it may be a C or a C++ or a Java or an Ada, Python, Perl, Ruby, etc. Any programming language. So any programming language which supports object-oriented programming system is called as an object-oriented programming language. Now, what is object-oriented programming system? An object-oriented programming system is a combination of object, class, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, and encapsulation. So if there is one programming language And that programming language supports classes, objects, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, encapsulation. If that programming language supports all these six things, and there are some sub things, I will show in the next slide. Keep the things in your mind. So if any programming language supports all these six things and their sub concepts, is called as an object oriented programming language. Remember all these 6 points, right? So for the entire Java, we are going to talk about all these 6 points, right? Object, class, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, encapsulation. Okay, I will explain what is an object, what is a class, what is inheritance, what is polymorphism, what is abstraction, and what is encapsulation in the next session, right? So here, if any programming language, as I said earlier, it may be any programming language. It may be a C, it may be a C++, or a Java, or Ada, or Python, or Ruby, or Perl, etc. Any programming language, if that particular programming language supports all these 6 concepts and their sub-concepts, is called as an object-oriented programming language, right? So remember all these 6 things. So let us move to the next slide. And these are the some of the sub-concepts. Okay, these are some of the sub-concepts. When I say inheritance, there are multiple types of inheritances, right? So the types of inheritances are single, multiple, hierarchical, hybrid, and there is one more inheritance called as multi-level inheritance, which was not included in the diagram, right? So I'm just showing the different types of inheritance, not all the types. So here we have an inheritance is further divided into different types: single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, hybrid inheritance. As I said earlier, any programming language have to support all these 6 concepts along with their sub-concepts. If I say inheritance means not only inheritance is further divided into single, multiple, multi-level, hybrid, hierarchical. So any language has to support all these sub-concepts of inheritance if that programming language should be represented as an object-oriented programming language, right? So at the same time, polymorphism can also be divided into 2 types, compile-time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism, right? Compile-time and runtime. So the I will explain it. What is compile-time polymorphism? What is runtime polymorphism? What is single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, hybrid inheritance, etc. in the next classes. Don't worry with that. Just remember the concept. Only we are focusing on how Java is an object-oriented programming language. We are focusing on that question. So if any programming language wants to be object-oriented programming language, then it has to support the 6 things: class, object, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, encapsulation. At the same time, along with these main six concepts, it has to support all the sub-concepts also. Some programming language may support compile-time polymorphism. Some may not support runtime polymorphism. That means that particular programming language is supporting polymorphism, but in turn, it is not supporting runtime polymorphism. But if a programming language wants to be object-oriented, it has to support all the 6 main concepts along with the sub-concepts also, right? So, next one. So this is the point what I am speaking from the last 2 slides. The language which supports all the OOPS concepts, that is object-oriented programming system. Right, we have seen in the second slide, this is the object-oriented programming system. Right, all the 6 and their sub-concepts. Sub-concepts means all these are the sub-concepts of those main concepts. So the language which supports all the OOPS, that is object-oriented programming system concepts, and their sub-concepts. Right. When I say polymorphism means it may be a compile time or runtime. It has to support both the things. And I say inheritance means single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hybrid inheritance, hierarchical, etc. So those are the sub-concepts. So the language which supports all the OOPS concepts and their sub-concepts is called as an object-oriented programming language. So let us look at the different programming language, whether they are object-oriented or not, in the next coming slides. So let us move to the next slide. So first one, let us start with the C. So the basic, the world of programming, the basic major part of programming begins with C. So here we have already seen the C programming language in the first semester. So C programming language is not an object-oriented programming language. So C is not an object-oriented programming language. C is a structured-oriented programming language. If you remember the basics of C programs, when we deal with the basics, it is said that C is a structured programming language. But C is not an object-oriented programming language. Because why C is not an object-oriented programming language? It does not support the object-oriented programming system concepts. We never discussed classes in C programming language. We never discussed objects in C programming language. We never heard the word inheritance while we are dealing C programming language. We don't have polymorphism in C programming language. C programming language never supported abstraction, and there is no encapsulation in C programming language. Don't worry, I will show the definitions. As I said earlier, I will show the definitions of each and every OOPS concept in the future session, that means in the next session, right? So C language does not support any of these things. There are no classes in C. There are no objects in C. C does not support inheritance. Polymorphism cannot be done in C. There is no abstraction in C. Encapsulation is not possible, not done in C. Right. So because of that, there is no support of any, even one of the OOPS concepts. C is not an object-oriented programming language. Right. So let us look at the next one. That is C++, the successor of C. Successor means the programming language which came from C. Let us look at whether C++ is an object-oriented or not. Right. C++ supports all the OOPS concepts, but it is not fully object-oriented programming language. As I said, C++ supports all OOPS concepts. We have classes, objects, inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation, and abstraction. It supports all the six concepts. Still, C++ cannot be called as a fully object-oriented programming language. Instead of that, we call C++ as an partial object-oriented programming language. Why we call it as a partial object-oriented programming language? Partial means up to some extent. Partial means we can say up to some kontavaraku. Kontavaraku C++ ni manam object-oriented anchu. Endukani manam kontavaraku antunnam ante. So what is the reason behind calling the C++ as a partial object-oriented programming language in the sense? Why we are calling it as a partial object-oriented programming language in the sense? C++ violates the rule of encapsulation in terms of main method. So when we are dealing with the programming languages, each and every programming language contains main method. We all wrote some programs in C in the first semester. You may remember or not, we used a main method called as void main. So similarly, for each and every programming language, we will have one main method, right? So C++ programming language is violating violation means it is not following the rule, right? The violating the rule of encapsulation in terms of main method. So C++ is not following the rules of encapsulation in terms of main method, not in terms of other methods. That program may contain n number of methods. Among all those methods, we can represent only one main method, but that particular main method was not following the rule of encapsulation. So let us look at what is encapsulation, and then we can discuss how it is violating the rule of encapsulation, right? So what is encapsulation? Wrapping up of variables and the methods which operate on those variables is called encapsulation. So keep one thing in mind. So for some important points, I am going to explain the things in Telugu, because most of the people who are listening this video came from the Telugu medium background. So they may understand, they may not understand when I speak the entire session in English. So that's why I'm explaining some of the important points in Telugu, right? So the definition of encapsulation is wrapping up of variables and methods which operate on those variables is called encapsulation. So ante entante oka program rasetappudu manam variables ni methods ni renditni use chestam. So konni variables ni rastam, dani kinda method rastam, ante ye method aithe aa variables meeda aadharapadi manaku untundo aa method ni rastam. So aa variables ఆ మెథడ్ రెండు కూడా మనం ఓపెన్ గా వదిలేయకుండా ఆ రెండిటిని ఒక బ్లాక్ లో ప్లేస్ చేస్తాం. అలా బ్లాక్ లో ప్లేస్ చేయడాన్ని మనం ఎన్క్యాప్సులేషన్ అని చెప్పేసి అంటాం, రైట్? సో ఒక బ్లాక్ తీసుకొని ఆ బ్లాక్ లో వేరియబుల్స్ ని మెథడ్స్ ని పెట్టే కాన్సెప్ట్ ని మనం ఎన్క్యాప్సులేషన్ అంటాం, రైట్? సో వ్రాపింగ్ అప్ ఆఫ్ వేరియబుల్స్ అండ్ ద మెథడ్స్ విచ్ ఆపరేట్ ఆన్ దోస్ వేరియబుల్స్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఎన్క్యాప్సులేషన్. Right, I will show one example so you can have a better understand. So let us see. So let us consider one example. There are three variables. So the three variables are of integer types, that is int a comma b comma c, and the method which will work on these three variables is main method. So here I have represented main method with some additional keywords. So this is how we will represent main method in Java programming language. Java lo main method ilage untundi. So in Java the main method will be as public, static, void, main, string, args. So I will explain all these keywords. What is the use of public keyword and what is the use of static keyword, and what this void keyword is used for, and what is a string and args, etc. in the next sessions, in the future sessions, don't worry. So here main method will operate on those three variables int a comma b comma c, and we will never let the main method to be in open. We will bring main method into a block. We will have a open braces and a closed braces, and in between that open braces and closed braces we will represent the main method. So this is how Java's main method is represented. Java's main method is always wrapped in the sense it will be kept inside a block. It will never let be open, right? So Java's main method was wrapped in a block. So and that wrapping of that main method inside a block is called as encapsulation. You can observe the diagram. That in the diagram, encapsulation is represented by two lines. Those two lines, in the first line there will be open braces, and in the last line it consists of a closed braces. That means we are wrapping means keeping the things in a block. Wrapping, what we are wrapping, if you move to the inside the block, there are three variables and there is one main method. So we are wrapping variables and method. So wrapping up of variables and methods is called encapsulation. That's what we have seen in the previous slide. And this is the previous slide. you can see the definition. Wrapping up of variables and the methods which operate on those variables is called encapsulation. And that is the definition of encapsulation. And this is the definition what we are going to see in the next session also. And for the remaining five concepts, I will show the definitions. I will show the definition for the class, object, inheritance, polymorphism, and abstraction in the future class. Right? So, encapsulation means we have to keep everything in a block. Either it may be a variable or a method, we have to wrap it and we have to keep it in a block. That is encapsulation. But how that encapsulation was there in C programming language, if you observe the main method, we just write the main method as void main. We just write the main method void main, and there will never be use braces here. One second. Right, and there will be never be braces like this. Right, we will never use these type of braces, and we will never encapsulate this main method. We will never use this type of braces. We will represent the main method at outside. So main method will never be encapsulated. That's why in C programming language there is no encapsulation. At the same time, we don't study C++, but remember one thing. In C++ also, right? C++ supports classes. C++ supports objects. C++ supports inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, and encapsulation also. C++ supports encapsulation. But that encapsulation is supported only in terms of other methods. C++ never encapsulate your main method. That main method in C++ will be represented as open. C++ main method will never be inside the block. So that's why C++ is violating the rule of encapsulation only in terms of main method. Right? So we will write the main method in C and C++ as void main and the body of the main method here. We will never use it a block in order to wrap this main method. So that's why in C++, only main method is not encapsulated. Other than main method, each and every method is encapsulated. C++ strictly follows the rules of classes, strictly follows the rules of object, and strictly follows, supports all type of inheritances, all type of polymorphism and abstraction also. But C++ main method is not encapsulated. That is the main reason why we call C++ as an partial object-oriented programming language. Right? C does not support any of six concepts. That is why it is not an object-oriented language. C++ supports all the six concepts. But encapsulation rule is violated only in case of main method. For other methods, we provide encapsulation in C++. But in case of main method, it is not following the rule of encapsulation. That is why C++ is called as a partial object-oriented programming language. Right now, all of you would understand. Next one. And next, coming to the next programming language, we have completed C and C++. Now we move to the next programming language, and the name of the programming language is Java. And Java is an object-oriented programming language because it supports all OOPS concepts and sub-concepts. As we saw, that six different OOPS concepts and their sub-concepts. Those are class, object, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, encapsulation. And the sub-concepts in the sense, inheritance can be further divided into single, multiple, multi-level, hybrid, hierarchical, and polymorphism can be divided into static polymorphism and dynamic polymorphism. So Java is going to support all these six and their sub. That is why Java is called as an object-oriented programming language, right? But there is one condition. But frankly speaking, right? Frankly speaking, we cannot call Java as a pure object-oriented programming language. Java is an object-oriented programming language, but Java is not a pure object-oriented programming language. See the difference. Java is an object-oriented OOP language, but Java is not a pure OOP language, that is object-oriented programming language. It is not pure. Why I am saying not pure in the sense, before going to see, so many of the websites or textbooks may or may not represent it. That means most of the textbooks and most of the websites may represent Java as an object-oriented language. I also obey it. Yes, Java is an object-oriented programming language. But frankly speaking, Java is not an pure object-oriented programming language. There is one question. Why Java is not a pure? Java is an object-oriented language. But why Java is not an pure object-oriented programming language? So let us look at why it is not pure object-oriented. So Java does not support multiple inheritance concept directly. Java does not support the concept of multiple inheritance directly. So we already saw different types of inheritances. Single, in the third slide we saw single, multiple, multi-level, hybrid, and hierarchical. Among all those five types of inheritances, right, Java is not going to support multiple inheritance concept directly. So it is not going to support the multiple inheritance concept directly, right? How it is going to support this multiple inheritance concept? It supports, see the second point, it supports the multiple inheritance concept up to some extent. And konta varaku support chestundi. Ela support chestundante by using interfaces. So there is one concept called as interfaces in Java programming language. I will explain what is an interface, how to create an interface, how to use interfaces in programming in the, I think it may be in the third unit or fourth unit. I will explain there. So just keep these two points in your mind, right? Java is a object-oriented programming language, but Java is not a pure object-oriented programming language. Why we are saying that it is not pure in the sense? So the reason behind that one is Java does not support multiple inheritance, right? Does not support multiple inheritance concept directly. So it is supporting that multiple inheritance concept indirectly. Indirectly in the sense, it supports multiple inheritance concept up to some extent by using interfaces, right? It does not support the multiple inheritance directly. It supports the multiple inheritance concept up to some extent by using interfaces. That is why we cannot call Java as a pure object-oriented programming language. That is the main reason behind why we are calling Java is not a pure object-oriented programming language. Because it does not support the multiple inheritance concept directly. It is supporting multiple inheritance concept indirectly up to some extent by using the concept called as interfaces. Right? Next one. Then, which language is pure object-oriented language? We saw that C is not an object-oriented programming language. And next one, C++. Is partial object-oriented programming language because main method is not encapsulated. And Java, it is object-oriented programming language, but not pure because it does not support multiple inheritance directly. It supports multiple inheritance up to some extent by using the concept called as interfaces. Then what is the programming language which is pure object-oriented programming language? the answer for this question is ADA is pure object oriented programming language. Why ADA? ADA is one of the programming language similar to C, C++ and Java. So that ADA is called as pure object oriented programming language. Why we call this ADA as a pure object oriented programming language in the sense, that is the reason, the last point in the slide is the reason it supports all the concepts and their subconcepts of object oriented programming system directly. So ADA supports classes, ADA supports objects, ADA supports inheritance, ADA supports polymorphism, ADA supports abstraction, ADA supports encapsulation. It is supporting all the main six concepts of OOPS. At the same time, the inheritance is further divided into five types: single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, hybrid inheritance. So it is going to support all the five types of inheritances directly. And then coming to the polymorphism, polymorphism can be divided into compile time polymorphism, runtime polymorphism. So those two types of polymorphism is also supported by ADA directly. Because of this reason, we call ADA as a pure object oriented programming language, right? So now, I think if any of you don't understand what I am saying, and if any of you cannot match with my speed, you can just move backward, somewhat backward. This is a video, we can move backward. We cannot move forward, right? We can move backward and you can see which concept you are lagging. That means if you understand any one slide, you can move to the slide, right? You can move, you can drag to the slide and you can see the video later. No problem with that. Still, after watching the video twice also, if you have any doubts or if you don't understand any concept, you can just make a comment in the comment box of this video and I will answer all the comments. Don't worry. Learn Java programming language, right? If you are perfect in C, then 30% of Java programming language is completed, because the succeeder of C is C++ and the succeeder of C++ is Java. So the total the concepts like variables, the concepts like operators, right? And then iteration loops. Iteration means while, do while, for loop, conditional statements, that means if, else, all these things are taken from C language only. So if you are perfect in C, then 30% of Java is completed. So for those concepts of C, we are going to add some object oriented concepts in Java, right? So if anybody is having any doubts regarding this session, or if you don't understand, or if you don't match with my speed, you can just move to the particular slide and watch the video again. Still, if you don't understand, just leave a comment. Just put a comment in the comment box. I will answer the each and every comment that was in the comment box, right? And if you are unable to comment in the comment box, just take my number and just give me a message or call me and I will explain. Don't worry about that. And let us see what we have seen so far in today's class. So finally, we can say C is not an object-oriented programming language. Why? C does not support classes, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, encapsulation. But C++ is partial object-oriented programming language. Why? Because it supports classes, objects, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, encapsulation also. And it supports the subconcepts. For example, types of inheritance: single, multiple, multi-level, hybrid, hierarchical. And then, for example, polymorphism, runtime polymorphism, compile-time polymorphism. All these things are supported by C++. But the main method in C++ is outside. That means we never encapsulate the main method in C++. That is why C++ is called as partial object-oriented programming language. When coming to Java, It is an object-oriented programming language, but still, Java is not a pure object-oriented programming language. Why? Because in the types of inheritances, there is one type of inheritance called as multiple inheritance. That particular multiple inheritance is not supported by Java directly. Java supports that multiple inheritance indirectly by using the concept called as interfaces. And then we have seen ADA. ADA is a pure object-oriented programming language because it supports all the six main and different sub-concepts of the object-oriented programming system. Right? Coming to the next slide. So we don't have much time and it will take about 40 to 50 minutes. So that is why I'm not going to cover this particular solution for this particular question. So how Java is machine independent? So I will cover this particular topic in the coming session, right? So with this, I am going to close today's session. So I am going to close the today's session. Right, I'm going to close today's session. And as I said earlier, if you have any doubts regarding today's session, right, if you have any doubts regarding today's session, just move to the slide and watch the video again. There is an option, you can watch the video any number of times. And still, if you have any doubts, you can text me or leave a comment in the comment box so that I will answer. And then I request all the listeners of this video, if you are beginners of Java, please listen to this video perfectly. Right, please follow all the videos. This is the first class, don't worry, and from the next sessions also we will continue. We will start with the basics and then we enter into the simple things in Java and then we move to the some of the complex concepts in Java. Right, so if you learn Java perfectly, there are much more opportunities which are waiting for you in the IT world. Right, so if you learn Java, you will get a job definitely with minimum of 20 to 30,000. But not only the things which we are discussing here are the core Java, right? So Java, we have core Java and advanced Java. Here we are only discussing core Java, and advanced Java you have to learn by your own, because in our syllabus we don't have advanced Java concepts. We only have the core Java concepts. So if you learn the core Java perfect, you can easily learn by yourself advanced Java concepts, right? So listen to the videos carefully and clear your doubts by using the comments or by texting me. And in the next session, we will see, right? In the next session, we will see how Java is machine independent programming language, right? And I thank each and every listener of this video for being here from the last 45 minutes. And I really thank you, everyone. And I will meet you in the next session. Thank you and thank you. Thanks a lot.